To help us make sense of today's market movements, we're joined by Jerry Alfonso. She's the equity analyst at Regina Capital Development Corporation. Good afternoon, Jerry. Thanks for joining us.
Good afternoon.
Yes, the rally to 6,400. Don't you think it's too much too soon, considering the givens have not changed globally, with more economies still battling recession possibilities? I mean, are today's market prices already at precarious levels?
With the recent market movement, the rallies over the past sessions came out strong, and I would say that this was driven by the good third quarter performance of the firms. And we all know that the general global outlook is still uncertain. However, we are not hearing any major news that would drive the market negatively. The concerns are still there, but I think it's being enveloped by the positive news. So the market participants seem to be very focused on the third quarter figures. They've been kind of shrugging off the impending global worry, and investors are forward looking to the holiday season. And historically, there's always a Christmas rally. So yeah, I would say given the current movement, the index could probably trade in the range of the 6,200 to 6,400 with the remaining months of the year, as long as there's no major negative news that would prompt it or prompt the market to tumble.
That is, of course, on the case of equities. But Jerry, things are looking interesting in the bond segment following the approval of San Miguel Corporation's 40 billion bond offers and Aboitiz Equity Ventures' almost 20 billion offer. Both, of course, are meant to raise capital for various endeavors. Are you optimistic about them, given prevailing equities jitters? Can people put money in them instead?
Well, SMC, they have logged a loss for the third quarter of their net income, about around negative 6 billion, and that was a triple digit decline year to year as forex volatility continue to impact the group's earnings. Although year to date it revealed that their revenues hit 1 trillion, which kind of wowed investors, but for me, SMC may appear to be somewhat unattractive compared to its blue chip peers because of the continuous decline in their quarterly net income. But so far, if we take a look at the chart, it's been consolidating for quite some time now, indicating that there's a support in this stock. So, yeah.
All right. Corporate stories now. The MWSS approving the water rate hike petition. So what does this mean to concessioners, given inflation pressures to expand and improve services and rising water demand from post-COVID normalization?
Well, now that the MWSS regulatory office already greenlights the water tariff hikes, we could expect that this could propel the water concessionaires' revenue to grow in the remaining months of the year, since this decision by the regulatory board is favorable to them, adding that, as you have mentioned, there's a rise in water demand as the economy reopens. So yeah, we could assume that their top line will grow, and this could serve as a good catalyst for this water firms in the next trading sessions for the year.
And I've got another one, Jerry. Prime Infrastructure seeking license extension to proceed further extractive activities at Malampaya following the November 1st takeover of their gas-to-power project. Let's also note that Prime Infra is moving its planned IPO to next year due to poor market conditions. What's your take on this?
The volatile market conditions are inevitable at this point. So it's unsurprising that Prime Infra chose to defer their planned IPO, much like the other companies as well, that decided to postpone until sentiment kind of ease or improves. So this is not so much a reflection of the company's fundamentals. In fact, the latest developments that you mentioned, the license extension for further exploration, are testament to its strong fundamentals and its dedication to keep the local industry stable. So all in all, it's still looking good for Prime Infra. The company's portfolio bodes well to the government's goal. So, yeah.
All right. Lastly, Jerry, on the earnings front, Emperador's Third quarter revenues down more than 10% on account of higher input costs and, of course, minimal price increases that they've implemented. EMI shares down 0.2% today, more or less. What's your outlook for the stock given the upcoming holidays when demand is expected to surge?
Yes, the higher logistics and input costs really took a toll on the company's earnings. But I think Emperador is attractive right now. Their products are going to boom during the holiday season, both domestically and internationally. And if we are to look at the chart, despite the confluences of headwinds during the previous quarter, Emperador managed to trade above its 100-day MA, making the long-term trend still intact. So investors of Emperador during the previous months are already on a gain right now. And all things considered, Emperador is still good to invest. This stock is still good to hold.
All right. Jerry Alfonso, equity analyst at Regina Capital Development Corporation. Thank you so much for joining us and for your market guidance.